Why do we spend so much on healthcare, both individually and as societies? Because we think the healthcare works. But how do we know that? For some drugs, like penicillin, when it was first introduced, it was obvious that it was effective. And for some treatments, like appendectomy, it's long been obvious that if a patient had appendicitis, then surgery would almost always save them from death due to peritonitis. But for most treatments, for most diseases, the effects were less dramatic, and so it was not so obvious that a new treatment was more effective than an old one. And so we imported from agriculture the randomized trial as a technique for evaluating interventions to tell us whether or not they were effective. To do a randomized trial, we formed two or more groups that are alike in every factor that might affect the outcome of treatment, except the treatment itself. One group gets the new treatment that we're interested in, and the others get an alternative, perhaps an older treatment, perhaps usual care, perhaps an inactive placebo. Because the groups are otherwise identical, any difference in outcomes is then due to the difference in treatments. So if the treatment group did better, then it's the treatment that's responsible for that improvement. Comparison of the outcomes thus reveals the effects of the different treatments. This was electrifying for healthcare and triggered a golden age for the invention of new treatments. We now have around 500,000 randomized trials and know an enormous amount about what does and doesn't work in healthcare and medicine. As time went by, though, we were trying to detect even smaller effects and smaller effects. And in order to make our trials sensitive to these small differences, we started to eliminate the patients whose conditions, perhaps they had several conditions, or whose advanced age or less than perfect adherence to their medication might even slightly reduce the impact of the treatment we were interested in evaluating. And as a result, the people in these trials, the institutions in which the trials were done, even the clinicians providing the care within these trials, became less and less similar to the usual patients, communities, and practitioners in whom we hope to use these treatments once we've shown that they're effective. As a result, trial results have over time become less and less applicable and thus less relevant to our use in deciding whether or not to implement a particular intervention or treatment. I'm Marek Swarenstein from Western University in Ontario, Canada, and my colleagues at the Karolinska Institute from Aberdeen University in Scotland and elsewhere will be providing a course of 6 weeks on randomized controlled trials. And we hope that we'll be able to help you design your own trial and through this process understand how best to design a randomized trial that answers the decision that you are trying to make in healthcare.